To factor with algebra tiles, you need to already have an understanding of how to multiply with algebra tiles. So I'm going to start by referencing that and saying that when we multiplied with algebra tiles, I would make a chart like this, and one of my factors would go here, and one of my factors would go here, and my product went in the middle. Well, since factoring is really just undoing that multiplication that we've already done, we're going to start with the product in here, and then see if we can guess what the factors were on the outside. If you remember multiplying by algebra tiles, you know that this product in here will always make a perfect rectangle. So what I want to do is I want to start by modeling my product with algebra tiles and seeing if I can arrange it into a rectangle. Well, my x squared plus 6x plus 8, and if I remember, the x squared always went up here, and then some of these x values would go on the bottom and on the side, and then my units would go over here. So let's try this combination to factor. Let's see. I'm going to try to fill in. It looks like that didn't work. If I try to arrange x squared plus 6x plus 8 like this, I have a hole right here. So I know this isn't the correct factoring. So this would have been, if it had worked, this would have been x plus 3 times x plus 3. But as we know, and as I can check by multiplying it back out, that wouldn't have worked, because there needs to be something that goes right here. So I'm going to try to rearrange my product in a way that makes a perfect rectangle. I wonder if I could do it like this, and then, well, no. I know that that's not going to work, because then I have three tiles left over. So if I tried x plus 5 times x plus 1, I know that wouldn't work. So I'm just going to keep trying to arrange these tiles until it makes a perfect rectangle. And now that I see that I can arrange my product in a way for the factors to be x plus 4 times x plus 2. And once again, I know this is the solution, because once I arrange all of my product into a rectangle with my x squareds up in the top left and my units in the bottom right, it makes a perfect rectangle with no holes, and everything adds up completely. I can check it by multiplying it back out.